What's up everyone, in this video I'm going to show how you can convert multiple Excel columns or rows into one array with the TOCOL and TOROW functions. Then I'm going to show how you can also use these functions to remove duplicates from a list or create a dynamic drop-down list. I'm going to start off with the TOCOL function. In this worksheet I have a range of data where column A shows a list of items and column B and C shows the number of items sold for each quarter. We want to turn the three different columns into one single column. In cell E2, I'm gonna type out equals to TOCOL, tab, and we have three arguments, the first one being mandatory, and the last two are optional. We want to focus on the mandatory argument first, which is array. And for our array, we're gonna choose everything from cells A2 to C5, and we can even freeze the cell references in place if we want. F4, and press enter, and we get back a list of single column outputs, starting with the item, then the two quarterly numbers, and then the item, and then the two numbers again, and so on. You'll notice that in our original range, we have blanks, and in our output, we have zeros where the blanks should be. One easy way to fix this is by concatenating the original function with nothing. If we go back to the formula bar, we can type out ampersand, and then just type out nothing with the double quotes, press enter, and as a result, all the numbers are getting treated as text, but in return, all these zeros disappear and gets returned as blank instead. Instead of coursing these zeros into blanks, what if we wanted to directly remove the blank values from the output instead? Well, that's where the second additional argument comes in. I'm going to remove the concatenation from the function, and inside the function, I'm going to type out comma. For the second argument, we get a list of options where we can type out the default value of 0 to keep all values, or 1 to ignore blanks, or 2 to ignore errors, which I'll get to soon, or 3 to ignore both blanks and errors. I'm gonna type out 1, press enter, and now you can see that the blank values from our list disappeared. But you'll notice another problem. We have a divisible by 0 error here. If we want to get rid of any errors, or hide any errors, then we can choose number 2 instead, without hiding the blank values. But if we do this, the blanks came back. If we want to hide both blanks and errors, then we can just choose option number 3. And our list becomes smaller. The final optional argument for this function is scan by column. You basically have the option of choosing the default value false, which will scan the array on a row by row basis, or true, which will scan the array on a column by column basis. If you choose false, then the values getting appended would start from cells A2, then move on to cell B2, then move on to C2, then cell A3, and so on until you reach the last cell. If you choose true, then the function would start at cell A2, then A3, then A4, then A5, and then move on to the next column in cell B2. So let's choose true instead of false here. If I do tab, press enter. Now we have the value starting from columns A, and then the remaining values from columns B and C. Now that I've shown what TOCOL can do, I can move on to the next lesser used function, TOROW. TOROW works very similarly to TOCOL. The only difference is that it outputs the result as a single row instead of a single column. We're gonna use the same range of data as before. In cell E2, I'm going to type out equal to TOROW, and we have the same arguments as the TOCOL function. For the array, I'm going to choose everything from cells A2 to C5, and we can freeze the cell reference if we want, comma. For the ignore argument, we're going to choose the number 3 so that we can ignore both the blanks and errors. And we're going to return the default value false so that we can scan on a row by row basis. And we get back the outputs as a single row, apples, then 10, then 15. Then orange, we're gonna ignore the blank and the error, so we're gonna get back bananas here, and then so on. If we want the function to scan on a column by column basis, then just change this false to true. And we get the list of items first, and then the numbers afterwards. Let me show you an example of how you can use these functions with other functions like unique. We have a list of fruits across three contiguous columns from A to C. We want to find the unique list of fruits for all items in that range. This is going to be a very simple formula. In cell E2, I'll start off with equals to TOCOL, select everything from cells A2 to C4, freeze the cell reference, comma. We want to ignore all the blanks and errors, comma, and we can just leave this as false. Press enter, and we get back a list of fruits, including duplicate items. We want to remove the duplicate items next, so we can wrap this around with a unique function. In front of the equal sign, type out unique. And we can just use this function as the array argument, press enter, and we get back a list of unique fruits this time. Now the cool thing is that since you referenced the entire range, if you updated a value here, like watermelon, then that gets added to the list too. For the last example, I'm going to show how you can make your own dynamic drop-down list with the TOCOL function. I have another set of three contiguous columns that contains the fruit name for each. The data is stored in a table or a list object. So what I'd want to do is create my own drop-down list by referencing a formula that returns a sorted unique list of each fruit name. As we add more fruits to the table, the drop-down list will get updated automatically. In cell E2, I'll type out equals to TOCOL. For the array argument, we're going to reference the entire table, which I gave the name fruit table. For the second argument, we're going to choose number 3 so that we can ignore any blanks or errors that might pop up. And we can leave the third argument alone as the default value. We get back a list of fruits, including duplicate ones. The next thing we want to do is that we want to remove any duplicate fruit names appearing. We can use a unique function before TOCOL to do this. The array will be the entire function, and we can leave the other two arguments alone, and we get back a list of unique fruit names. The next thing we want to do is that we want to sort this in descending order from A to Z. So we can use the sort function right before unique. The array will be this entire thing, comma. We can leave this argument alone, and the sort order will be in ascending order from smallest to largest. And then just close this out, press enter. And now our list is sorted from A to Z. Once we make the formula, we can reference it in our drop-down list in cell F2. Start off by selecting cell F2, then go to the data tab, go to data tools, and select this arrow, data validation. Click on data validation. And what we want to do is that we want to change the setting to go from any value to list. We can leave these alone, and our source will be equal to cell E2, with both cell references frozen. And the next thing we want to do, which is key, is that since this is an array formula that spills down values, we want to reference this hashtag symbol so that it can identify that this is a spilled formula. And whenever we add a new item to the table, the formula gets updated automatically. Click OK. And if we click on this toggle here, we have a list of fruit names now. So if I select Kiwi, the name Kiwi will appear, and same thing for Apple. The cool thing with the setup is that whatever value you add to the table, the drop-down list gets updated automatically. So let's choose a random blank cell in cell C4. If I add watermelon, press enter, we get watermelon appearing in column E. And if I select the drop-down list, watermelon appears here too, which we can select. Since this is a table, any item you add to a new row gets appended automatically. But if I add cherry here, press enter, we have a new row in the table, and we have cherry appearing here, and cherry appearing in the drop-down list. That's pretty much it on how you can use the TOCOL and TOROW functions. These functions are useful whenever you want to convert multiple contiguous columns or rows into a single column or row. If you're interested in learning about an Excel trick, then check out this video I made before, where I show how you can use the flash fill feature to automatically update data entry for you. If you found this video to be helpful, then please like and comment down below what else you'd want to see. And if you haven't already, subscribe. You can also follow me on Instagram and LinkedIn to get notified the next time I upload a video. Until then, I'll see you all again next time.